We just need to assemble a really good group into this room and get everyone nice and comfortable. I see Ducks there and looking. I'm going to get to how he's looking because he's got something he's got to do.
He's got something special,
hasn't he? Just he's just a, and real happy. He's happy enough with himself, Duck, isn't he? But at the minute, he's got real happiness about what he's visually bringing to the table.
Yes.
So he's at the other end of the spectrum from Bill. He's got no reason to be happy. But nice to see you.
I'm happy with myself. I look in the mirror and very happy. I see some changes today in today's game, boys. Four for the Suns, seven for the Saints. So good luck to you and Brian Corbett today.
Hello to you, Dave.
Hello, Jim. Hello.
Bit of news antenna out of last night. I'm going to ask you about that.
Lots
in
of weights
out
last night.
Yeah, there was. And of course, and Brian, and JB, the much travelled.
I have got a, I think it's the world's best untold story.
I have been told this by our producer.
And this is untold, unheard. This is real. It's a real story. It's really untold.
Right.
It is really, really incredible.
Better than Nath Brown's?
It's fresh.
Fresh?
It's fresh as. Not even the player and the coach knew that I knew.
Hello. Ooh.
And it was between the two of them.
Hello.
And so just wait for this one. This is a crack.
Where you know that Bristol's onto something is when he gives you the look out of the side of his eyes.
Yes.
Like just gives it the, just give me some room.
I've got one.
He's got a real, the pinky red shirt he's got on. He looks vibrant.
He was,
looks up and about.
I'll tell you what he looks to me, is fresh out of Fitzroy.
Yeah.
You've either got the up from lawn look or the fresh out of Fitzroy.
I've had this
watermelon.
Apricot watermelon style thing sitting in the cupboard at Fitzroy where all the clothes that I don't wear go to Fitzroy.
The second and third.
And I ran out of clothes.
And Jim, you know what he's also got? He's got a different hairstyle to the one I saw on TV last night when he was roaming the Essendon room. So you had your weekly cut.
And the moustache gets a bit of a trim too, doesn't it?
All right, well, you finished with all my looks. Let's talk about Ducks, what Ducks wear.
Crisp. Well, I'll tell you where you know Ducks got something nice on, when the white shirt comes
crispy
out. That's what I've noticed.
Crisp.
Because
it's a crispy one.
He rolls normally, and then often with a T-shirt that's barely sort of able to hang on.
Exactly.
But then when there's something coming up, the white crispy comes out.
Well, this is the button version.
So come on,
the buttons are bursting.
What's going on, Duck? What's going on?
Well, we've got the 99 Bill.
Yes.
Premiership reunion today. So
what are they like?
Hey, what are they like? Well, yeah, very good question.
Who's going?
So looking forward to that. Every single player's going other than three.
Oh, three not going.
Three not going.
Legitimate not going.
Legitimate
excuses.
Reasons. Peter Bell can't
Working
make it. Who, by the way, was very good on that day in 99. Was absolutely brilliant. He's working at Fremantle, so can't come over.
No, that is Bristol. He will be sadly missed. A very, very popular player.
Yeah, very popular guy.
Melbourne.
Very funny. Very funny guy. Yeah. Not a... When you get a one or two cold ones, and even funnier.
Second best on ground
and
behind
then
Shannon Grant.
Yes, and then the other one that's not going, which I only found out today, although he has, I've sort of been just letting his calls go through to the keeper, because sometimes he can keep you on the phone for a little too long, and that's big Corey McKerkin.
Big Causer.
Big Causer.
Is there someone else that's not going?
He's well, yeah, but I didn't even know he was playing, so I'm not going to mention him. Shane Clayton.
Don't be disrespectful.
I'm only joking.
Is Cameron Mooney going?
I believe so. He was there.
What about his stats for the day?
Yeah, what were his stats?
Well, I'm just
Bill,
looking kicks.
You don't have to back over Moon.
Well, when you play badly,
player.
When you play badly in a grand final, it's good to see others do too, Jim. Cameron Mooney, no kicks. So 0-0-0-0
Bill.
For the four quarters.
The Moon was a baby at that stage.
Then I go to the handballs, 0-0-0-0 And then I go
you
to
got
the,
a tap out.
I go to the tackles, 0. I go to the marks, 0.
That's a bad game.
Freeze, for and against, 0-0.
What about Horse Longmire?
I was about to say, let's run Horse's numbers by.
Horse had
1.
0-0-0-0 kicks.
Oh,
so no
really?
Kicks. Three handballs.
Duck, you carried him.
Three tackles.
Oh, Horse didn't have a kick.
And no goals.
So three possessions, Horse. No possessions, Moon.
The two big
men. And the eventual margin was about 40 points.
And, Peter Bell kicked four goals.
Yeah, no, he was good, Belly. Very good. So only three not going, so it'll be a great day,
right,
JP.
It will be a great day, and we look forward to hearing about it as soon as we can get you back on the mic afterwards. But the other thing that interests us is... We would normally attack a game like today with a full stats barrage.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, Damo,
Where is he? Little Chuapalo.
Little Chua is going as Ducks plus one to the 99 Premiership reunion because he reckons he was doing the stats.
He texts me this morning, the Chu man, and I actually thought he would be in here today at least.
So did I.
Contributing something. At some point.
Something.
And I got a message this morning saying, Hey Duck, hope you're well, mate. Just let us know if you want me to swing by the studio later today in an Uber to pick you up. And we can go to the reunion.
Together.
No stress either way, Ash.
He's getting a bit buried in it, too, man.
Swing by. He was the stats man.
So now he's wanting to travel with the king.
Yeah, that's it.
To the reunion.
To the reunion.
And now Ash. Now,
my response, all good, buddy. I'll meet you there.
Well, when you actually do the geographical analysis, Bristle, he's coming from Point Cook, thinking he's going to slide by South Melbourne before going to Fitzroy. Yes. Nowhere near on the way. So he's trying to get a bit of duck rub off.
Yes. Walk in.
He thought, maybe when I get to the given said venue, maybe the cameras might be there and I might be clicked getting out with Duck.
Well, he's he's a big name now.
No one actually saw him there.
I'll tell you where he'll be, or someone will be saddled up right next to him all day. D King, right next to him.
Just trying to get a few extra
stats.
They'll have a champion data off.
They'll have a stat off.
War room.
I'll look over and Kingy will have a whiteboard and Shoeman will be there like Poindexter.
Why don't you get Kingy today to take you through some of the great moves of the 99 game on a whiteboard?
Yeah,
he could talk you through that.
Wow.
Absolutely. Talk you through it.
Bore me to.
Clayton had three touches that day too. So you had a bloke
three players and six between them.
Six between them with three players.
How'd they win? One by 40.
Look at Bill. He's buried himself into this game harder than any you've ever been involved in.
I love it when they don't get a touch.
So at least the thing with this Damo and Bristle and Duck, at least the people attending today were involved in the game, as in playing
as in
for the winning team.
Played, yeah.
There have been two reunions recently, one in Perth for the West Coast Eagles.
And one tonight, Jim.
And one tonight.
Hawthorne's 30-year anniversary when they won in 89.
Bill has been offered cash to attend both.
Yes.
He took the cash to attend West Coast as a member of the team that they beat. And there's. I'm wanting to know if the Hawthorne one you're actually going to front up to tonight.
I got asked. I'd like to have someone from the other side.
Just to laugh at? Or what?
Yeah, well, I was on a panel. I got asked to go on a panel.
Right.
But unfortunately, I'm out at Park Orchards.
Oh, yeah.
With Glenn Archer. But he's obviously at your function.
Yep.
Yeah,
with a fatter envelope.
Well, but higher pay.
Yeah. No, this is just doing something for the Park Orchards Footy Club out there, Jim, and my friend at Mazda.
So when you went to the West Coast one, this fascinates me. Yeah, John Worsfold, Monkey Brennan, Glenn Jakovich,
Bluey McKenna.
Bluey McKenna. They must have looked and thought, what are you doing here?
Actually,
we beat you by 100 points. How are you here?
Oh, I looked around and all the stars were there. And Mick Malthouse. And I did say,
Was it worth the cash?
Oh, well, actually, because I reckon they got up on stage and they wanted to say how bad we were, Geelong. But they couldn't because I was sitting there.
Clearly shows Bill will do anything for
him. Anything.
Yeah. Oh, don't you? Now, Brian. What's that aim yet? I see you doing. What about that aim yet?
Oh, that's just part of integration for Seven. That's all part of the deal.
And then I saw you doing the Thursday night footy, which you're not even calling, I see. I see Jim and Bristle.
Jim's a company's lunch.
No, Bristle was doing the Triple M.
No, I know, but he's doing the ad where it's, wow, Thursday night footy is coming to Seven.
Did I?
Oh,
I didn't even remember that.
Oh, Brian.